Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Cryptids and Critters Paranormal. I'm your host, the Dooster. Today I want to share with you a couple little stories that came out of my book, Eye in the Sky. If you would like to purchase one or some of my books, they're available on Amazon. They're also available from me at my home here. I have a bookstore called Soggy Bottom Bookstore. It is on Facebook. You can go there and kind of look around and see what's in the books, and it also give you the price. The only thing I'd be added to the price would be shipping if you do want a signed copy. If you do, send me an email to ghosthunter911@gmail.com. That is ghosthunter911@gmail.com. And I'll make sure you get a signed copy delivered to your mailbox. The story I'm going to relate to you today occurred in 1897. 1897 was a very busy year for UFO sightings, as reports came in from all across the nation. In fact, historians have labeled it the Great Airship Wave of 1897. This first one I'm going to tell you about occurred probably pretty close to where I live now in the northern part of Robertson County. It was around 8:30 on the night of April 16th, 1897, that the residents of northern Robertson County reported seeing a strange, unidentified flying object in the sky. The object was visible for about an hour and caused a lot of excitement in the area. The main body of the flying object seemed to have been constructed of steel and was estimated to be about 25 to 30 feet long. On the front of this object was a large light similar to and about the same size as the one used on locomotives during that time period. Positioned on the rear was what appeared to be a large red lantern. On both sides of this mysterious object were large projections that appeared to be some type of propeller or some type of wings. The object hovered in the sky at an altitude estimated to be about 3/4 of a mile high and remained stationary for a good while, and then darted off until the light appeared to twinkle. Witnesses stated it could travel very fast. The unidentified craft made its way south and soon disappeared into the darkness. Eyewitnesses also state the unidentified object was also seen in the skies over Clarksville, Tennessee, and neighboring Montgomery County, as well as northward into neighboring Adairville, Kentucky. Among the reported eyewitnesses that night was a Robertson County resident by the name of John Sarr, and it is stated that at least 40 to 50 people saw what they described as an airship. The sighting struck fear in the hearts of the black residents who witnessed the strange event. Many were stricken with terror and ran into church crying and shouting, proclaiming the millennium is at hand. Many of them called it a monster. Based on eyewitness accounts, a local artist rendered a sketch of it, which I'm going to put on as a thumbnail to this video, and you can look at it there. Starting in late 1876 and on through May of 1897, numerous mysterious large airships, powered by propellers and decorated with some type of electric lights, were reportedly flying over Michigan, California, Texas, Tennessee, and Arkansas. And the question is, who built these airships and for what purpose? Balloon flights were nothing new, as they had been recorded in Europe as far back as 1852. Hot air balloons were used by both Union and Confederate forces during the War for Southern Independence. By mid-1897, at least two patents for airships had been awarded to a couple of American inventors. But it wasn't until 3 years later, in 1900, that the first successful and very short Zeppelin dirigible flight took place in Germany. In April of 1897, during a court trial in Harrison, Nebraska, a large airship was witnessed by jurors. judges and lawyers, who declared a recess from the proceedings and assembled outside the courthouse to witness the strange event. The airship remained motionless in the sky over the courthouse for more than 30 minutes and was also witnessed by many of the town folk. The oval-shaped craft was a bright white light on the front, had colored lights all around it. It had a box-like structure hanging beneath it, a large propeller-looking device at the stern. To this day, though well documented, there have been no explanation to the sights observed. Another sighting of a mysterious airship allegedly took place on May 6, 1897, near Hot Springs, Arkansas. As the story goes, a couple of sheriff's deputies were investigating reports of cattle rustling near the community of Jesseville. The two men were on horseback when they saw a bright light in the sky. The light soon disappeared behind the hilltops, and the men continued on their ride. After a few minutes, they again saw the light, but this time it was much closer to the earth and appeared to be descending. It once again disappeared, but a half a mile down the trail, the men's horses suddenly stopped in their tracks and refused to proceed further. Peering into the darkness, the two officers quickly saw the reason why. Directly ahead in a small clearing sat a mysterious craft of some type, and people could be seen moving around it with some type of light. Drawing their weapons, they slowly approached to investigate. Demanding that the mysterious people identify themselves, the two lawmen were startled when a man with a beard approached holding a lantern and announced that he and two companions were traveling the country in an airship. He showed him his unusual craft, which they reported to be cigar-shaped and about 60 feet long. The mysterious man tried to coax him aboard the craft, but they flat out refused. And later that night, when they passed by the same place on their way back to town, there was no trace of the airship or its mysterious occupants. Now, exactly what those two deputies saw that night remains a complete mystery, even to this day. Airplanes and powered blimps had not yet been invented in 1897, yet newspaper reports across the country were filled with reports of sightings. Some speculate that the late 19th century eyewitnesses saw a spaceship from another planet and that the inhabitants were actually aliens. Others believe in a more earthly explanation. Either they were experimental aircraft that was being kept secret, or it was an outright hoax. It's interesting to note that a resident of the Hot Springs area applied for a patent for a flying machine at about that same time. He did not receive his patent, but obviously was experimenting with some type of aircraft. Now, whether he ever actually constructed a flying machine or not is unknown. Whatever those two lawmen saw in mountains that night remains a mystery and is still unidentified to this day. No claims of responsibility for the incident have ever surfaced. And not long after the above Arkansas incident, a man in Mississippi reported a similar encounter with the airship and described the craft in much the same way. And bearing the discovery of more evidence, the 19th century UFO sightings will remain another one of those unsolved mysteries. The sightings of these strange craft diminished after the summer of 1897. But in 1909, sightings of the mysterious airships resumed and were witnessed across the United States, as well as Britain, New Zealand, and Scandinavia. Their origins still baffle us and remain a mystery to this day. Well, thank you for watching. If you like my channel, subscribe to it, give me a like, share it with your family and friends. And once again, this is Dooster with Cryptids and Critters Paranormal. Have a good day, and we'll catch you the next time.